everybody, this is your professor here. In this video I'll be explaining what are fractals. Now everyone likes to invest or trade in the stocks market or your currency market or your futures market or the options market or commodity markets. So if you are doing that investment or trading without any system or just pure guesswork or on the tips of somebody else, then you are just purely gambling. It is not an investment, it is not a trading. So you should have some sort of system for doing the investment or trading. Now the system or the method or the strategy which people are looking for are usually the ones which are almost 100, which will always give 100% success. But that is not possible. You can never have a strategy which will work all the time. That is 100% success you will never get. There will be always 50-60% success in a strategy. Very rarely you can come across a strategy which is having a higher percentage of success. So the best way to trade or invest is to have a system and follow its rules. The most of the people in the market or most of the people who are investing or trading, they lose the money because they do not have discipline. They do not follow the rules of their system, or they do not have also a system. They are just blindly doing the trading. So always remember that if you want to succeed in the trading or investment, you should know what to invest, when to invest, how much to invest, and when to sell. These four factors you should always have in the beginning before you do any investment or trading. Otherwise you are just purely gambling. So what are the rules? What are the factors? What to invest, how much to invest, or trade, how much, what to trade or what to invest, how much to invest or how much to trade, when to invest, and when to exit or when to sell, right? So without these four things beforehand, before you do an actual investment, these four things you must have in front of you, then only you'll be able to succeed. And also you must remember that if the trade is not successful, if a trade hits a stop loss, then you must exit without any hesitation. If you are trying to delay the exit after a stop loss it hit, then you are only inviting trouble for yourself, right? So these four factors you have to consider. Now what to invest, you can do with the help of fundamental analysis or with the help of technical analysis. Fundamental analysis, you know, it involves the study of the balance sheets and the economic activity of the country and all those things which are mainly done by the accounts people and the chartered accountants and MBAs and all that. Whereas technical analysis is the study of charts. Now charts reflect everything. So although some people may say that technical analysis is bogus, but those who are doing it, they are doing it well, and those who are not doing it, they are not doing it well because they are not following the rules and they are not disciplined enough. Most of the people who are MBAs and CAs and all that, they are failing, many of them are failing in the market because they are trying to search for a perfect system. That because as such, when they are doing before they do your MBA or CA or engineering or whatever, they have been taught to get 100% correct answers. That is possible only in exams, but in the real life, in a real practical situation, that is not the case. You will not have a perfect trading system where you can get 100% correct results. So you have to manage those things with the help of stop losses, right? So even if you get a slight edge of, suppose your system is 55-65% accurate, then you can still win, provided you control your losses. Okay, so in these this video and the forthcoming videos, I'll try to explain simple methods of trading and investments. Now, one of the simple method involves fractals. What are these fractals? Now, if you know that if you are having a chart, in a chart you will get bars or candles. All those who are familiar with the charts, you'll find that there are bars or candles. Now, whether you are having a bar or a candle, it will have a high and a low, and because of that you will get because of the bars and candles you will get fractals. Now let us see what are the fractals. Here I have shown here a picture in front of you where there are five bars, and the upper one has got an arrow down. The blue bars are having an arrow down, and in the lower part of the picture the green bars are having an arrow up. Now you must have guessed what are these or how they are formed, but still let me explain you that. Fractals are of two types, down fractals and up fractals. Now I've shown here both the down fractals and the up fractals. Let us see one by one what are the fractals. What are down fractals? Now in a set of five candles or a bar or bars on a chart, you can see on the right side there are five candles or five bars. If the middle bar has the lowest low, then that set is called a down fractal. So it's very simple, it's not very complicated. If you have five bars, you just have to look at the middle bar, and that middle bar's low should be lower than the side two bars. It has got both the sides, it has got two candles. The middle bar has got two candles on the right, or two bars on the right and two bars on the left. The middle bar's low should be lower than the remaining four candles or remaining four bars. Like if you take your hand and put it downward, your middle finger is, your hand will look like a down fractal with the middle finger having an arrow down. The side two fingers which are there, they will be having a higher low, okay, and the middle finger will have a lower low. Now what is the significance of these fractals? The third bar low, which is the part of the fractal, can act as a good support. If a price is coming down, then this region of the third bar low, the area of the third bar low, the price near the third bar low will act as a good support, right? We'll see about this when we discuss the strategies, but right now we are only considering what are the fractals. Let's take up the next one. What is an up fractal? In a set of bars or candles, five candles or bars on a chart, if the middle bar has the highest high, then that set is called an up fractal. Okay, so here in the right side you can see five green candles or five green bars are shown. The third candle or the third bar has having the highest high. On the side, the remaining two bars which are there on the right side and the right left side of the middle bar, you'll find that the highs are lower than the high of the middle candle or the middle bar. Now the side candles, they can have, what I've shown here is that the first candle is having a lower high, second candle is having a higher high, then first one and the third one is having a highest high. That need not be. The only condition should be that the third candle should have the highest high. The first and the second candle, they may have, the first one may have a higher high than the second one may have a higher high than the first one, okay? So that is not important. Only thing is that the middle bar should have the highest high. And also remember that till the fifth bar is complete, a fractal is not formed, okay? Till the last bar, fifth bar is complete, you cannot have a fractal complete, right? So then you can only act on this fractal after the fifth bar, that is in the sixth bar only. Whatever you want to do, buy or sell or whatever you are doing, that is possible only after the fifth bar, okay? So till the fifth bar is complete, the fractal is not formed. The third bar can act as a very good resistance. In an uptrend, if you are encountering a fractal, then that upper, the third bar high of that fractal will act as a good resistance. Now you can have a peculiar situation where you can have a middle candle which has got a highest high and the lowest low. So in this situation, you have both an up fractal and a down fractal in the same set of 5 candles. Now this type of fractals are very rare, but they do occur. And in that case, the middle candle will act as a strong support and resistance for the future candles, right? So that middle candle will be a very big candle, so it will have a higher high and it will have the highest high and the lowest low of the 5 candles. So in this, both the fractals are there, up candles and down candle, up fractal and down fractal. Okay, so I hope you have understood what are the fractals. Up fractals are, down fractals are a set of 5 candles in which the third candle has got the lowest low, and up fractal, the third candle has got a highest high. Now we will see in the next video. I'm keeping my videos very small, of 5 to 7 minutes, so that you don't have to listen to large long videos, and you don't have to listen to my promotion. I'm not going to promote anything. No, I will not waste your time on promotions. Other videos, if you see on the net, they are all the time promoting something, but that is not my intention. I'll just give you the material which is to be used. Okay, so let us see the fractals on an actual chart, which we'll do on the next, in the next video. I'll be ending this video right now. So if you have liked this video, you can share it and press the like button, and thank you for listening to this or seeing this video.